The Education Committee report on the ministerial policy statements in the Ministry of Education, which was presented by the chairperson of the committee, John Twesije, noted that higher institutions of learning have threatened to discontinue students under the public students loan scheme due to failure by government to pay tuition arrears amounting to 14.59 billion shillings.
The committee recommends that Minister of Finance urgently allocates Higher Education Student Financing Board additional 20.664 billion in 2023-24 to enable 4,189 students already on the scheme to continue with their studies and to enable 1,500 new cohort attain higher education by accessing loans through the board.
Arrears started accruing in 2021-2022 financial year, and it worsened in the current financial year as the government released only 7 billion out of the 33 billion that was required by the High Education Students Financing Board, which manages the program. Twesije noted that universities have threatened to drag the government to courts of law under delayed payment of tuition.
We asked universities to avoid litigation due to non-payment. They made MOUs with universities, and some of the universities, especially private ones, are threatening to sue the board.
The program is currently sponsoring 4,189 continuing students and plans to sponsor at least 1,500 first-year students. However, only 10 billion out of the 30 billion which was requested by the High Education Students Financing Board has been allocated in the 2023-2024 financial year budget. High Education Students Financing Board in 2014 received 6 billion and sponsored 1,201 students. In 2018, it recorded the highest enrollment when the board gave loans to 2,943 students after the government released 29.5 billion shillings. However, numbers started dwelling in 2019-2020 to 1,851 in 2021-2022, 1,146 and in 2022-2023, 600. Members of Parliament have tasked the government to reverse the budget cuts on the critical item and also find money to clear the outstanding tuition arrears.
They told us that they don't have money for the arrears and they don't have money to pay for the new intakes. So our worry is with the new districts who are just coming up with education, if we don't, they don't provide money for that, how are we going to proceed with our people?
It is now incumbent upon the budget committee to look at the wasteful expenditures, mostly about areas to fund the presidency, areas to fund the special presidential advisors, areas to fund non-important businesses, especially these facilitation that are not clearly captured in the budget, retooling that is not clearly captured in the budget. Those ones should be able to raise money enough to fund the student's loan scheme.
The committee recommended the government to phase out sponsorship of best performing students at university and channel funds to the High Education Students Financing Board. The committee found out that majority beneficiaries of government scholarships are children of rich who can afford the best schools, which score best grades.
We have realized that most of these, the 4,000 students who are admitted on merit to these universities, are from the high-notch secondary schools, which are charging a lot of money, and therefore the students that can qualify from there are students of the rich.
Parliament has also recommended the government to provide 15 billion shillings in the next financial year budget to rehabilitate traditional public schools, which are currently in a dilapidated state.
15 billion be allocated each financial year towards the rehabilitation of these old traditional schools where most of the infrastructure is in dilapidated state, in order to ensure delivery of quality education services countrywide.
How do you fail to provide money for this? The Minister of Finance, why are we wasting time? Including securing, we are moving up and down in the policy development model. We are not providing this money.
Report compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.